What's in a gas mixture has been hard to determine. OGS will change that. You heard all about it in the last episode with Shuko and Melina. I'm Jeff's voice avatar, and I have more details for you about how the fantastic OGS works and how it was developed.
From know-how to wow.
AI-hosted deep dive.
To measure the exhaust of a chemical reaction, it's today not really possible. It's very complex in the setup.
Alex Stratmann wants to change that. He is the head of development for the OGS. OGS is short for Optical Gas Spectrometer.
You can say, hey, chemical industry, you want to know what's happening in the gas phase of a reaction? Put the gas to the OGS and you will see it.
Alex makes it sound easy. Using the OGS measuring gases will indeed be easy. But developing the OGS was a huge challenge. The device relies on Raman spectroscopy. That's a method of measuring tiny shifts in light frequencies caused by the electrons of a molecule.
Light is an electromagnetic wave with a special frequency. And if you put this wave on these molecules, then the electrons vibrate with the same frequency as this light. And if you have vibrating electrons, they emit light with this frequency. So light in with one frequency, and due to the vibration of the electron, lights out with the same frequency. This is the so-called Rayleigh light.
Most of the light that is emitted is Rayleigh light. Unfortunately, it is not useful in this case. But there is a small amount of light that is different and more useful.
The electrons are in connection with the core of the molecule. So it is bounded. And this gives a shift of the vibrations of these electrons. And this shift is characteristic for the setup of the molecule. And this shift in vibration gives a shift in their radiation. And this shifted radiation is the so-called Raman light.
The Raman light of a nitrogen molecule differs from the Raman light of an oxygen molecule. The problem is that it's very weak. Typically, big, complex lab setups are necessary to measure Raman signals from gases. To turn those setups into a tabletop device, Alex's team had to redevelop crucial components of a Raman spectroscopy setup.
Especially our light source, the laser, is developed from the beginning. And all around the optics, the way of the light, how we detect it, this is, let's say, new development.
These new components led to a significantly stronger Raman signal. This makes it possible to shrink everything into a shoebox-sized device.
If you compare it with the described laboratory setups, we have about 100 times more Raman signal. And that makes it possible to measure the gases.
The lab setups are not only large, they are also unique. Each one differs from the next. Alex and his team had to find a way to make series production devices that are identical, that cover a variety of use cases and applications, and that deliver consistent results.
They all must work in the same way. And this makes it interesting, to do it, and also complex.
Alex says that's the strength of Bosch, industrializing experimental setups and turning them into robust systems.
How to make a product in an industrial way? This knowledge you don't learn in 1 year or 5 years.
So his team relied on the know-how and experience of Bosch. Many problems, big and small, had to be solved. Here's an example.
What we have to learn that depending on the gas mixture, you have gluing on the surface. Or if you have condensing, then you get liquid on the walls.
When the gas flows through the OGS, it can interact with surfaces inside the device. One way to minimize this is to make the gas channel as short as possible. The channel is made out of stainless steel. There's a glass window for the laser to shine onto the gas. The most tricky component to prevent from interacting with the gas is the sealing gasket between the stainless steel and the glass.
To find the right sealing, which is stable enough for a lot of gases. It's not, it's a complicated one. You will not find one sealing which fits for all gases.
The gasket material might have to be customized depending on which gases a customer wants to measure using the OGS. Which brings us to the question of which gases can be measured in the first place. As you learned in the episode, in theory all gases, except noble gases, can be detected by the OGS. But it isn't known for all gases what their Raman lines look like. It could be a lot of work figuring this out.
It's not the way that you put one guy in a lab, and deliver gases or liquids and measure the vapor, then he is working about the next 20 years.
That's because there are a lot of different gases, essentially as many as there are liquids in the world.
Each liquid has a gas phase.
But the OGS itself will help in building up a database of Raman lines, because the OGS makes measuring Raman spectra so easy.
And now we are starting to measure a lot of gases, and then we are starting to make these databases. It's a complete new possibility, and therefore we have a new possibility for different applications.
The more people use the OGS, the more previously unknown Raman lines will be added to the database. This will eventually allow the device to detect more and more complex gas mixtures. Because when more data is available, that enables the use of AI algorithms.
At the beginning, we use classic algorithm, how to fit the spectra, to analyze and overlapping things. But with increasing data, we will not go to millions of gas spectra in 1 or 2 years, but it step by step, it will go in that area. And then we can start to think about AI. And I will not say it's not possible. I think it's interesting and it will be possible. But first we need a database. And with the OGS, we open the possibility to get this database.
The OGS will be available this summer, but development of the device has not stopped at all. For instance, Alex and his team are working on a high-pressure version.
We can measure from vacuum to 40 bar in our standard version.
40 bars is the pressure that electrolyzers produce, for instance. So OGS can already be used for quality control in the production of green hydrogen. But at a hydrogen filling station, pressures are much higher.
Filling stations are up to 700, 800 bar. So it's one development step to make an OGS for 800 bar. Advantage is you see very small amounts of impurities, because with 800 bar you increase your sensitivity by 800 because of the higher density.
Bosch is part of a publicly funded project in Germany to research the measurement of hydrogen purity at filling stations. And that concludes our deep dive into the OGS, the optical gas spectrometer. I hope you learned something.
From know-how to wow.
AI-hosted deep dive.
In the next episode of From Know-How to Wow, Jeff and Shuko will share new ways of bringing artificial intelligence into cars. Foundation models can enable new driver assistance functions. How does it work? Stay tuned for the next episode.